Okay, and this is the last of our series of lectures on non-diagonalizable matrices, and we're going to look at what a power of a non-diagonalizable matrix looks like, or what the exponential of a non-diagonalizable matrix looks like. And by look like, I mean how it acts on a basis. And in our last video, we saw that there's always a basis of power vectors. So we really want to know what happens when a to the n or e to the at hits a power vector. We're going to do this in stages. We're first going to look at what happens when a to the n hits an eigenvector, then a power vector of degree 2, and then a power vector of degree p, and all of these guys are going to have eigenvalue lambda. We'll always write x for the eigenvector, y for the power vector of degree 2, and z for the power vector of degree p. And then when we're done with a to the n, we're going to do the same thing for e to the at. So, for a to the n, eigenvectors are very easy. If ax is lambda x, well, a squared x is a times ax, that's a times lambda x, and it multiplies by lambda a second time. Every time you hit it with a, you multiply by lambda. You hit it with a n times, you multiply by lambda n times. Piece of cake. But now, what happens if we have a power vector where a minus lambda I squared acting on y is 0, but a minus lambda I y is not 0? It's a bit more complicated, but not super complicated. You see, we can write a as a minus lambda I plus lambda I. And then we can take this is a sum of two matrices. Sum of two matrices, and we just expand it out using the binomial theorem. Now, the binomial theorem is a little bit tricky for matrices. It only works in the usual way if the matrices commute, if this times this equals this times this. But this is the identity. It commutes with everything. So the usual binomial theorem works. It's 1 of the terms to the nth power plus n times that term to the n minus first power times the other term plus n times n minus 1 over 2 times that to the n minus 2 times the other term squared, and so on. Okay? And of course, a power of the identity just gives you the identity, and then multiplied by something else gives you the something else. So we get lambda to the n times the identity, and n lambda to the n minus 1 times 1 power of a minus lambda I, and n choose 2, that's n factorial over n minus 2 factorial, 2 factorial, or n minus 1 over 2, lambda to the n minus 2, a minus lambda I squared, and then you have all the way down. Okay. And now we have to see what each of these terms does to y. So we write out a to the n y is the sum of all these terms. We say, okay, this is a vector. It's lambda to the n y. This is a vector because a minus lambda I y is some other vector. But a minus lambda I squared y, that's 0 because y was a power vector of degree 2. This term is 0. This term is 0. All the terms in our expression vanish except for the very first two. For an eigenvector, we only had the very first one. For a power vector of degree 2, we have two terms. And we get lambda to the n y plus n lambda to the n minus 1 times this vector, whatever it happens to be. So it doesn't go just as a power of lambda. You get a polynomial piece. You get an n lambda, n times a power of lambda, and you get a power of lambda. If you had a degree p, well, then the first p terms in your expression, all the way through the p minus first power of a minus lambda I, would work. And anything with p or more powers of a minus lambda I, those would kill z, but the rest would not. And there we have it. No matter how big a power of a you want, you always have p terms and no more than p terms. Okay. For exponentials, we do something very similar. If you want to exponentiate at, you write a as a minus lambda identity plus lambda identity. and we use the fact that this matrix and this matrix commute. In general, if you have E to the sum of two matrices, it's a real mess, unless the two matrices commute, in which case it just becomes E to one times E to the other. And E to the lambda IT is easy. That just gives you a factor of E to the lambda T. We get this from a power series. Identity, A minus lambda IT, A minus lambda I squared over 2T squared, A minus lambda I cubed, T cubed over 3 factorial, etc. The usual power series for an exponential. So there it is. It's A minus lambda I to the N over N factorial, T to the N. And it's all multiplied by E to the lambda T. So now if we apply this to an eigenvector, all the terms with factors of A minus lambda I kill the eigenvector, and you're left with just the very first term. You see, this term is 0. An eigenvector has A minus lambda I x being 0. If you have a power vector of degree 2, then the first term survives, and the second term dies, and the third term dies, and the fourth term dies, and the fifth term dies, and you only have to worry about the first two terms. If you have a power vector of degree p, you have to worry about the first p terms. So it is a bit more complicated than with eigenvectors. With eigenvectors, it's just, hey, multiply by e to the lambda t, you're done. With power vectors, you have an e to the lambda t term, you have a t e to the lambda t term, you have a t squared e to the lambda t term, you have a t to the p minus 1 e to the lambda t term. Now, these could have been derived by perturbing the matrix and taking limits and using L'Hopital's rule, but these formulas are really much easier done directly with